Hello viewers, welcome to my channel PC Geo Kimberlite, a source of diamonds. Today in this video we are going to see a topic from SYBSC fold chapter, classification of fold. In this we are going to see today the part 2, and in that types fold set 2 and set 3. And this set 2 has been based on the study of the attitude of the fold axis. So here, on the basis of the attitude of the fold axis, we are going to study the type set 2 and set 3 based on the appearance of fold with increasing depth in the earth crust. So this we are going to see, and earlier I uploaded already the part 1. Similarly, I uploaded the geometrical classification of fold as per the new syllabus of UGC. I am Dr. Sajid Undekar, Associate Professor and Head, Department of Geology, AKI's Pune College of Arts, Science and Commerce, Camp Pune, Maharashtra, India. Our college is affiliated to Savitribai Phule Pune University, and it is formerly known as University of Pune. Yes, let's start what we have today. We are going to see the two sets. We are going to see set C. The fold are classified on the basis of the study of the attitude of the fold axis. In that we are going to see the three important folds: non-plunging fold, plunging or pinching fold, or doubly plunging fold. In that, doubly plunging anticline, doubly plunging syncline. And similarly, the next type we are going to have, the folds are classified on their appearance with increasing depth in the earth crust. So these are, we are going to see in this particular topic now. These are, the first one we'll see the set 2, that is fold based on the study of the attitude of the fold axis: non-plunging, plunging, doubly plunging and sheet fold. Yes, the first one, non-plunging fold. What is a non-plunging? Very interesting one. You can see these three two sketches are there, and one is, the picture is there. So in that picture, if you see very carefully, say now this is a fold, anticline is there, this is a fold axis, and this is your axial plane. Now this axial plane is remain parallel to the axis of fold, or it is remain parallel to the horizontal surface, then this is called as non-plunging fold. Similar one, you can see here again anticline and AA dash, which is there. This is your axis of the fold, and this axis of fold is again parallel to the horizontal surface. So this is the non-plunging fold. Third one, photograph is there. This is again anticline. This is hinge. Now this hinge again parallel to this horizontal surface, that we called as non-plunging. Similarly, another photograph, you can see here, axis of the fold and this is the horizontal surface, both are parallel together. If you make out, this is the way we get the section. So non-plunging. But if you see the plunging, the fold is there, and now this fold axis is inclined, and with the horizontal surface here it makes an angle, and then it is called as the plunging fold. And if you take the section, we'll find out this is the way you're going to get the photograph. So plunging fold, and this is the non-plunging. Hinge line will be straight parallel to the horizontal surface, what we have in this. So this is the simple clear-cut first type of fold, that is the non-plunging fold. Come to the next one, plunging fold or pinching fold. Now in this, the axis of the fold is inclined. Say whatever your fold is there, say here we have the fold. Yes, this is the fold, you can see very carefully. Now this is what we have, is the axis of the fold. Now it is parallel to the horizontal surface, so it is the non-plunging. But once this is an incline, this axis of the fold makes an angle with the horizontal surface. You can see the angle, we can see very carefully. Then this will be called as the non-plunging fold. This is called as the plunging fold. It is, the axis of the fold is inclined or vertical, it is said to be a plunging type. So in this particular diagram, this is anticline. Yes, this is the, what we have, the fold axis. This is the axial plane. I can see axial plane is horizontal. It is horizontal surface. So with this, if you make here, we have the angle. So this angle will be called as the plunging angle, and this is what we have, the plunging fold or pinching fold. Yes, if the axis of the fold is inclined or vertical, it's said to be plunging. The plunge of the axis of the fold is the angle. Yes, what is the plunge one? It is the axis of the fold. Plunge of the axis of the fold is the angle made by the axis of the fold with its horizontal projection, and it is measured in the vertical section containing the both. In case of geological map of plunging folds, or the beds on opposite limbs strike towards each other and the formation of converges, and there will be the formation of converges. This will be there, that part will be there, so that we are going to make out. So in this, again you can see now, this is what we have, the non-plunge fold. You can see this plunging fold. Here we have again diagram non-plunging, plunging one, and this is the diagram we are going to see in the maps, the plunging one. You can see the model, how this will be, the plunging diagrams has been shown. So this is the way you are going to make out the plunging folds. Now, doubly plunging, there are the two plunge folds are there. It is said that it is a reverse its direction of plunge within the limits of the area under discussion. Most folds, if followed for enough distance, are doubly. If it is long distance, then it is called as doubly plunging anticline, doubly plunging. How you make out the differentiate? Both diagrams are looking same, but what is happening in the anticline? Limbs are dipping from the center to the periphery, but in the case of the syncline, from the periphery the limbs are dipping towards inside. So we can see in the next slide. Yes, here we can have doubly plunging. Now the anticline, from the center the limbs are dipping towards the periphery, and in the case from the periphery the limbs are dipping towards, it is a syncline. So doubly plunging anticline, doubly plunging syncline. So here we have doubly plunging anticline diagram, doubly plunging syncline. So here we have a photograph which showing you a doubly plunging fold. Next one in this last category is the sheet folds. The total angular change in the doubly plunging fold is typically less than 50 degrees, but folds with extreme curvature up to 180 degrees do occur are called as the sheet folds. So these are the sheet folds. Come to the next type. Folds are classified on their appearance with increasing depth within the earth crust. So here we are going to see the five types of fold: close or tight or similar fold, open or parallel or concentric fold, disharmonic fold, piercing or dipier fold, and the last one, supratenous fold. Close or tight or similar fold, you can see the word is similar. You can see the all whatever you have seen from one end to the another pattern is look like a similar one. And now you can see here on the limb side, yes, this side limbs, they are the thinner one. You can see they are thinner. But you can see in the crust, in the trough, both sides, you can see now the thickness is broad as compared to here. Thinner are there, here thicker are there. From the surface, if you go down, the beds are thicker, and the crust and the trough. This is the trough, this is the crust. So anticline, syncline, anticline, syncline. So these are the syncline. So these anticline, syncline, at this particular level, they are the thicker, beds are thicker, but at this level, they are the thinner. So what is happening? In this type of fold, beds are thicker at the crust and trough and thinner along the limbs. The length of the bedding plane remains same. From one end to end, the whatever the bedding planes are there, they remain same. They require sufficient intense deformation to cause plastic flowage. So here there is a moment, plastic flowage has been taken place of more mobile beds, resulting into thicker and thinning of the bed, and such folding can theoretically persist up to a great depth. Up to the great depth, you can make out, yes, similar folds are there. Thinner, you can see very clear. Thicker, you can see at this particular crust, trough, yes, you can see thinner at this level. same one. You can see limbs are very close and the crest and trunk, they are the thicker one. So this is what we have: close, tight or similar fold. The second one, open or parallel or concentric fold. You can see now, as you form the surface, if you go down, there is a change. What is this? This is what we have, the syncline. Yes, sharp angular edges are there, but as you go, round and round will be there. And if you go anticline, yes, as you go, more roundness and roundness, and it is become converted into the syncline. And you can see the syncline converts into the broader part, which is there about that part. So you can see again here the crest, which is there, the anticline, and as you go, more and more and sharp edges. So in this fold, form or shape of the bedding plane varies. Form surface, go to the depth, it is the varies. The thickness of the bed remain more or less constant. Everywhere, the crust, that is the limbs or crust or trough, you can make out, it is remain common, same, nothing has been changed. There is no considerable plastic flourish, so there is no movement has taken place. And due to that, lack of intense deformation. Length of the bedding plane decreases upward and downward. You can see, decrease on the upward as well as on the downward side. In case of such folding, anticline die upward. Anticline die upward and syncline die downward. This is the syncline die downward, anticline die upward. So this is the very, very interesting one in the open or parallel or concentric fold. You can see again the same one we have. We have a good photograph showing you the open or parallel fold or concentric fold. Yes, you can see here. Difference you can immediately recognize, same diagram which you already have seen. Yes, here also we have seen again the same diagram. So that is the open, parallel or the tight fold. Now next one, the disharmonic fold. This is the simplest diagram. Disharmonic, harmonic means the same wavelength. Wavelength which is there, the crest and trough, the amplitude remains same. But it is here, what is happening? As you go towards the from the surface, if you go towards the depth-wise, the fold is go on changing its shape. So one fold is converted into the another fold. So that will be there. So fold changes at the depth, then it is called as disharmonic folding. So here in this particular diagram, this is what we have, the axial plane. See the change, vertical, vertical, and now it has become the incline. But you can see on the surface, it is a symmetrical anticline. Yes, this is a symmetrical anticline. But as you go depth-wise, it converted to the asymmetrical syncline. And still if you go down, now where the completely the actual plane has been become the incline, there you can find out overturned fold. And if you go still down, where horizontal, then the recommended fold will come out. So symmetrical, asymmetrical, overturned, recommend this type of fold. We are going to get from the surface to the down, then this type of folding pattern will be called as disharmonic fold on the basis of increasing depth within the earth crust. Disharmonic fold is best developed on the some of the great cliffs of Alps or Himalayas and Himalayas, or they may be interpreted from the basis of the data of mines or drill hole. Wherever we have the mines, drilling data is there. So on that we can get the information and we can make out the study. Folding may vanish at the depth. So folding may going to vanish. So this is what we have, the various disharmonic fold pictures. The next one, piercing or dipier or salt domes. Another name we can put it over here. That is, from the lower side, a rock salt will be interrupted into the sedimentary rock. The sedimentary rock, horizontal one, as it pull out, it is bending. Thus, a dome like a feature has been formed. Piercing or dipier fold are the anticline in which the mobile core has been able to break through the more brittle overlying rock, and salt beds may break through the overlying rocks. Thus, these folds, which are developed during the upward movement of the mass, rock forming dipier. I can see the nature. Yes, you can see here thinner As you go upper side, thicker is there. But here, you can see thicker will be there on the periphery. So this is the dome-like a feature is going to form, and in the center we have the rock salt specimen which will be going to get gypsum, anhydrites we are going to get, or petroleum we are going to get it out. So these are what we have, the salts. Yes, you can see the folding pattern, folding will be taken place at this particular level. Yes, this is what we have, the perfect pictures. So this is what we have, the piercing, die pierce, or the salt domes. And the last one, supratenous fold. Supra means above, tenous means thin. So when the piercing, the due to the deposition at one place, what is happening? The one place is deposition, second place is the erection, and due to this upright, the whatever on the crust part, the undeclined part, will find out that whatever the thickness is there, it is become thinning. But where is the sedimentation which has taken place, it has become the thicker and thicker. Yes, it is subsidence, and thicker and thicker has taken place. So a fold which shows thinning or formation upward above the crust of the fold is termed as supratenous fold. And these folds develop if folding and sedimentation are contemporaneous. Sediments are let down at the same time, they get folded into anticline and syncline. So this is anticline, and the both side we have the syncline. The strata are thinnest at the crust of the anticline because it was rising during the sedimentation, while the strata are thickest in the trough, that is syncline, because it was sinking during the sedimentation. And I hope this will be clear, the fold classification, fold part 2, and in that we have seen type set 2 and set 3. I hope this will be clear, and earlier one, part 1, I have already uploaded, and those who want to see the geometrical classification, that is also uploaded. Then the terms associated with the fold, that has been already uploaded. So all the most of the structural part of the SYBSE I have already uploaded on my YouTube channel, that is the PC Geo Kimberlite or Source of Diamonds. Watch this videos and enrich your knowledge. If you have any problem or doubts are there, you can write down in the comment section. I can answer you, and if you don't understand any part, I can make video so that you can idea your thoughts, your ideas, your dots will clear and broader sense. You are going to become a good geologist. Thank you. Have a nice day. Enjoy. Thank you.